Hey, Shannon and Steve, you know, they are starting to gather right here, the bus drivers, for another protest. They're here outside Chris Abele's residence at the Moderne at Juno and Old World 3rd Street. They say they deserve more from the county. Now, this is just the most recent protest of many this past week. They say their work stoppage began on Wednesday morning, affecting thousands of bus riders in the area. But these drivers do plan to return to work overnight at 3 a.m. in the morning. We spoke with County Executive Chris Abele earlier today. He is not at home right now to witness this rally, but says he respects their right to protest. He says the county is not going to change their offer, which he believes is a generous one. He's worried it could lead to another work stoppage.
He won't take it to court.
What I hope is that if ATU has concerns, they can express them in a way that doesn't harm the people that we all agree, ATU too, that we should be serving, and they're the ones who are paying for it.
This great building.
And I'm joined by the union president right now. Talk about what you want to say, a few words.
The whole problem, if it's a fair contract, sign the paperwork to take it to court. But if it's a fair contract, step up to the plate. I already signed it. All we need you to do is have your cronies sign the paperwork. We go to court and let the federal government decide if it's a fair contract.
All right. Well, you hear it. No word on when this fight is going to stop. No word either on when mediation will resume. We'll bring you more on Live at 5. But for now, reporting live, Katie Crowther, today's TMJ4.
And Katie, what the union president is talking about there, the union has asked that this contract go to arbitration, that a third party is allowed to set the terms of a contract that both sides will then agree to. The county says it cannot go to arbitration because the financial situation here in the state of Wisconsin can't be compared anywhere else, and they don't want to get into a boat where they could be forced to agree to a contract that Milwaukee County taxpayers just can't afford. That's what he was talking about there. Clear that up for everybody at home. Katie Crowther, thank you.